Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 6.2, Problem 1. This is Section 6.2, Problem number 1. It says, the probability that Lenny the lawyer is lying is 43%. Use the binomial probability formula, n combination x times p to the x times 1 minus p to the n minus x, to find the probability that in the next 6 times that Lenny says something, he'll be lying twice. So what I like to do when I do one of these problems is start by writing the formula, n combination x times p to the x power times 1 minus p to the n minus x, and then off to the side, just write n equals x equals p equals so that we can fill in the formula. N is the total number of trials for the experiment. So in this case, n is 6 because we're going to see Lenny say something 6 times. So n is 6. X is the number of successes. So what we're measuring is that he'd be lying. So n will be 2 for twice. And p is probability of success as a decimal. So now the question gives it at 43%, but we can't enter 43% into the formula. We have to enter that as 0.43. So now we can go ahead and fill it in. N combination x will be 6 combination 2. And then p to the x is 0.43 to the x is 2. 1 minus p is 1 minus 0.43. To the n minus x, n is 6 minus x is 2. So the formula fills in that way, and before I really do any serious computation, I can clean up that right-hand set of parentheses a little bit, just do the subtractions. So I will have 6 combination 2 for the first parenthesis, 0.43 to the 2 for the middle one. But the last parenthesis, 1 minus 0.43 is 0.57, and the exponent, 6 minus 2, will be 4. So now what I have to do is get an answer for each set of parentheses. I'll have three answers, and I'm going to multiply those three answers together. So the first one involves combinations. So let me come off to the side a little bit and do 6 combination 2. So the 6, again, is the n, the 2 is the x, and the formula is n factorial over x factorial times n minus x in parentheses factorial. So now the n factorial will be 6 factorial. The x factorial is 2 factorial. In my parentheses, n minus x is 6 minus 2 factorial. And that I can replace with a 4. So I'll have 6 factorial over 2 factorial times 4 factorial. Again, the 6 minus 4, 6 minus 2 makes a 4. So the 6 factorial on top is 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. In the denominator, 2 factorial is 2 times 1. 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And now we can multiply all of that out and reduce, or what's a whole lot easier is we could at least 4, 3, 2, 1 on the top, 4, 3, 2, 1 on the bottom, and cancel that. Now on the top, 6 times 5 is 30. Underneath 2 times 1 is 2. 30 over 2 would reduce to 15. Or you could even go a step further, 2 goes into 2 once, 2 goes into 3, into 6, 3 times 5, you still get 15. So our first set of parentheses, I have 15. Now the middle parentheses, 0.43 to the second power, so that's 0.43 times 0.43. So 0.43 second equals 0.43 times 0.43. And that should be 1849. I'll check that though. Let's see. 0.43 times 0.343, yeah. 0.1849. So the middle parentheses, I have 0.1849. And now, the last set of parentheses, 0.57 to the fourth power. So 0.57 times 0.57 times 0.57 times 0.57. That I'll definitely need a calculator for. So, and the calculator will do that real quick. So, So when you do 0.57 times itself four times, the calculator is telling me the answer is 0.1055601. So now to finish the problem off, I'm going to multiply 15 times 0.1849 times 0.1055601, and that's going to be my answer. And when I multiply that out, the calculator tells me that is 0.29277068. Now, I don't want that many decimals. I don't need that many decimals. We can call it 0.29, or you can go 293 if you want. It's about a 29% probability for the final answer that if this person who lies a lot tells you six different things, two out of those six will be a lie. There's a 29% chance of that.